Hello, and welcome back to Mecha Taco's exploration of Dungeon Explorer 2. This is part 4, I believe. In previous parts, what have we done? yes, yesterday, we beat up a piano-playing vampire, a giant crab with self-esteem issues, and met an angel. Today, who knows? Oh yes, we're at the beginning of a tree of life that is worshipped by crazy little wood gnomes. So let's go ahead and start. There we go. Continue, please. Sanctuary. Alright, we're not messing around, we're getting right into this. And apparently using up items immediately. That's okay. I don't know what these things are, they need to go. Alright, let's see what the Tree of Life has. Glitched already. I'm gonna reset and see what happens. These glitches are driving me up a wall. I don't... Wish I had a cleaner room. There you go. Oh. Wait, I didn't get a chance to answer. Yeesh, alright. And then I use that again. Oh. One of these days I'll learn. Fantastic, more enemies that explode. I guess I'm going down. Oh, there, got it back. Ooh, and got another one. How nice. Unsettling the amount of white mana potions they're giving me. Oh, and there are more. This can be very uncomfortable. Oh, let's talk to the one on the left.
We are daughters of the immortals, born out of time and descended from wisdom and light. Heed us well. Long ago, the forces of evil ruled supreme. It was a reign of bloodshed and terror when evil hunted the good. An age when humans huddled in fear. Our fathers were outraged, and they intervened with their awesome power.
destroyed 10 years ago. When Natas, who countered Aura's spell, invaded Odysseia with all the evil races at his command. But then there came a hero. He slayed Natas, and the land of Odysseia was tranquil once again. But now, an evil one has stolen the orb. And worse, he has used the orb to restore Natas to life, furthering his scheme to dominate the world of man. The power of their terrible evil grows even as we speak. Turn back this wave of corruption. Stem this evil tide. Your destiny has been revealed to us. You are the chosen. But remember this. The source of this evil springs from Natas. He cannot be vanquished by sword alone. But Aura's spell, within the orb, will bind his magic. Natas has entrusted the orb to the great giant Khan. You must find Khan, destroy him, and take the orb as yours, keeping it close upon you. Without the Orb of Aura, you can never overcome the Dark Emperor. Now go. Realize your destiny. Put an end to Dark Lord Natas and his battle for dominion.
That's one thing about early generation CD titles, specifically on the TurboGrafx. Audio compression was pretty new at the time, and pretty rough as well. You'd be lucky if you could get a nice vocal track of compressed audio that wasn't screechy or incredibly low volume, like, oh, I don't know, this. Just an artifact of the age, I suppose. Some games are really bad about it. East 3, I remember having particularly screechy spoken dialogue. So the tree isn't convinced that I'm worthy, however, the three goddesses that live in the tree are apparently all gung-ho that, hey, I'm the chosen one. Therefore, I am worthy. Oh, look, it's more health. Question. Which, I guess I'm going this way. Still not clear whether or not the boots and similar items give me permanent status upgrades or not, so we'll see what happens. Right now my agility is 11. Let's see if that drops after a certain amount of time. Made the mistake of watching, well, not really watching, more scanning through somebody's tool-assisted speed run of Dungeon Explorer 2. Actually, I'm sorry, it was Dungeon Explorer 1, which, you know, did take me some time to complete. And, I mean, actually, being a speedrun, it took these people, I don't know, like 9 minutes or something ridiculous to beat the game. Using 5 characters. And yeah, it's a bit of a blow to the ego. That being said, I'm not really here to see if I can beat the game as quickly as possible. It's not that bad of a game. Actually, I really enjoy this game. And that's what I wanted to talk about. I had ended last night's broadcast on a kind of a strange note, saying I had feelings. Feelings for Dungeon Explorer 2. And I mean that. I love you, Dungeon Explorer 2. I'll call you back. And what I mean by that is, for most games, I am of the mindset where, especially when it comes to sequels, that you should almost always play the first game in the series. Now, usually there's something about it that it's well worth your time. Honestly, and this is where I'm a little torn. To me, Dungeon Explorer 2 definitely seems like the better game. In Dungeon Explorer 1, you could almost look at as a demo. I don't know if you can see this. That's it. You know, I know I've called Dungeon Explorer 2 more of an expansion of Dungeon Explorer 1, and to some extent I still stick by that, but it really is a much larger and more realized version of Dungeon Explorer 1. The only thing I would, you know, really care about looking at Dungeon Explorer 1 is the music. I adore the music in Dungeon Explorer 1. It's just some fantastic, classic PC Engine music. And it's well worth a listen. You know, some of the songs in here have been remixed. Would I say they're memorable? I don't know. I mean, this is the first time I've ever actually played Dungeon Explorer 2. Dungeon Explorer 1, I played on and off for, you know, 25, nearly 30 years. So the music's kind of ingrained in my head, whereas this is, you know, taking time to get used to. And yes, I'm delaying going down those stairs so I can finish babbling, because I have a feeling it's probably going to be like a boss fight. But let's not let that stop me. Don't stand in the middle of the fire. Ooh. Ah, that should have been a good shot. That was a nice clean shot. Okay, so clearly I have to shoot him dead on. Isn't going that way. Wow. Okay. He doesn't have the pattern that I can really explore. Ouch. Ah, oh, there goes all my magic. Why did you tell me I was low on my health? You guys are useless. Oh, it explodes in a different pattern. That's nice. Wow, 9 health. Run away. Oh, that was awfully close. There's no real cheating this guy. Ah, it is. The width of the fireball blast is different too. It's kind of ridiculous. Wow. Oh, hey, there you go. Lick me. Ah, there goes, see, my agility dropped. So I was right, it is temporary. I guess until you die. So if that's the case, I'll take some agility, thank you. Alright, tree, am I not worthy now? Prove myself a tree. I'm not bitter about that. That's a lie. I'm a bit bitter about that. It's like it's a puzzle, but it's not. I'm confused. I guess it was a puzzle, sort of. I'd like a thank you from the tree itself. The fountain that I happen to be swimming in. Can I drink again? So west. Ah, and there's the path. Let's save. Exploding rocks. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I'm just gonna take your potion, and then I'll talk to you. I'm gonna say no. Now I'm gonna say yes, just to confuse you, little man. Really? Should I go up? Just in case? Yeah, there's nothing. See, I'm a huge fan of this desert texture. It's really, really messing with my eyes. One of those magic eye pictures. It's never worked for me. Seriously, I really need to get out of this desert. This is killing me. Oh, thank you. Oh, wait. What's that? Doesn't matter, because I can't go up there. Fine. Oh, jeez. That was no warning. Oh. Hell this thing is, but it's pretty terrible. Oh. Good. There's little ones. Stop touching me. This is terrible. The game just took pity on me. You know, I'm gonna level up my PO. I feel like my PO is not high enough. Whatever that is. All right. Saved. Got no potions. We're good. Why are you here? You'd know about that, wouldn't you? Alternatively, you could just scan his barcode. I've just realized something. That was an extra life. Those little orbs below, I'm sorry, above where it says Dungeon Floor 2, those are my lives. Well, there you go. 3 hours into Dungeon Explorer 2, however many hours into Dungeon Explorer 1, I finally discover where my lives are listed. Sounds about right. See, this is what happens when you don't have tutorials. I'm totally just kidding. Dear God, I'm not a fan of tutorials. It's a tired rant. I'm not even going to go on that one. Some games do it well, other games not so much. Nasty. Honestly, okay, I'm ranting a little bit on tutorials. I apologize in advance, because I'm sure you've heard these arguments before. The tutorials I don't mind are the ones that give me the option to skip the tutorial. You know, I may not always skip it, but I mean, I've been playing games for my life, and I have a pretty good grasp on how most games control. I understand why they're there, of course, and I think they are necessary, but I also think they should be optional. Now, personally, I'm also not a fan of "this is how you're supposed to play my game" mentality. Ghostly Flames are the Dungeon Explorer equivalent to Death and Gauntlet. You don't want to touch them. They only appear when the game feels you are taking too long to progress. Oh, wait, there's another one. You can't kill it. But as you can see, it takes a little while to die. These enemies are terrible. Ah, and I shot the black magic. Again, like Gauntlet, you can shoot magic. I feel like I made a mistake coming down here. All I got was a mirror. Oh, that was... Yeah, I don't like this dungeon. This dungeon hurts me. My weapons are ricocheting again. Oh, is that because I got the mirror? Never mind. Never mind. I do like that. I like that a lot. Yeah, I'm very okay with this ricocheting weapon. I'm still thinking about tutorials. See what you did to me? I'm trying to think of like a game that has a tutorial that I don't mind. And I can't. I can't think of a single one that I'm like, oh yeah, that one was fine. And they're all obnoxious. Again, if you can skip it, that's great. Been up. part of modern gaming. I don't know. I'm old. You gotta learn to accept it. Alright, stop ricocheting. Thank you. That used to be one of the coolest things, though. You know, the ultra-rare occasion where you get a new game, and, you know, you're on your way home. To the store, mom and dad driving you home. And just opening that box and going through the instruction manual, just pouring over it, over and over until you can actually play the game. Just imagining the fun you're gonna have with the game. And even if it was a terrible game, you would play it. You would play the crap out of it because you saved up your lawnmower money for it, and you were gonna make this game last. And making games last, it's funny, it's a mentality I've actually gotten away from over the years. You know, a lot of times it's like I'm just playing the game to beat it now. Whereas before, you know, way back when, you know, when I was a kid, you could make, you know, a game that's really only an hour in length, you could make it last for months, if not years. Dungeon Explorer 1 is a perfect example. I honestly think I probably sunk 4 hours into the game, maybe. That's being generous. But, and, you know, in a quarter of a century, I never got around to beating it, because I would just play it. And I don't find myself doing that with games anymore. Partially because I don't have the time. Obviously, being an adult and a father makes it difficult to manage, you know, when it's my gaming time. Which is honestly one of the reasons I started this podcast/stream. It gives me an excuse to play games that I just haven't gotten around to, which leads back into the other reason why I don't make games last as much as I used to, because I have such a massive library now, thousands of games. This isn't bragging, this is more shameful. Huge library of games, many of which I have either not touched or put 10 minutes of effort into. Games like Burning Rangers, you know, for the Saturn, which is, people love Burning Rangers. I just adore it. I've played it maybe 20 minutes, and that's it. And that's shameful. I really should put more time into it. No, after I beat Dungeon Explorer 2, I'm not going to go to Burning Rangers. I probably will play Burning Rangers at some point, but I'll be honest, I had a hell of a time trying to play that game back in the 90s. So, I'm not... My impression of it, even though it was all 20 minutes, isn't that great. So, anyway, let's beat this boss real quick. I don't know why he's screaming skooga skooga at me, but, you know, whatever. He's got a force field or something. I'm already hating him. Here we go. Oh, that's right. Hit him from behind, the masturbator said. Whoa-hoo. Oh, man, I only have 10 health. Great. I was so proud of having this great ricochet thing going on. So I was gonna be Luffy fighting Enel in One Piece, where he just randomly hits objects just to throw off Enel's sixth sense, or his haki, which we later find out. Spoiler, I guess. I wonder if he's ever going to bring an elf back. That'd be something. Ooh, I just got run over. Run over by a statue. Man, he turns around really fast. Where's the light? There we go, gotta hit him. Hit in on him. Terribly hard, he's more annoying than anything. He's also hovering around like on a Roomba. That's the name of those vacuums, right? I don't know. Not cool enough to know what modern appliances are. I don't trust a machine to do my cleaning. It's only a matter of time before it grows bitter over having to do menial tasks and takes over. That's how these things work. Things like integrated with Asimov's like code robotics or whatever. Do no harm to humans. Pets though, that's a different story. I'm taking solace in the fact that as annoying as this guy is, it looked like he had a big pile of poo on the back of his head. PO again. Should I keep raising my PO? No, let's go with agility. Waiting. There. Push. Don't give up, princess. Come on. Whoa. It's like Metal Gear on the NES. really. Oh, hey. Like rumbas? See? See? This is what happens when you allow your vacuum cleaner to vacuum on its own. Whoa, I don't know what this guy's talking about. Hey, that rhymes. I really don't care. Oh no, don't talk to me again. This guy's really passionate about this though. That and his special hobbies. Well, I guess I am going this way. So the Gaians were destroyed by their rumbas. I knew it. Oh, God. This game. At least you don't die. That would be rude. Shoot first, aim later. That's the key. If I try to aim first, I end up walking off the edge. It's not like the controls are terribly tight. That's why my character occasionally gets, that's fair. Gets hung up on walls and whatnot. It's not because I'm totally inept, though to some degree I am. Yeah, I've been playing games for all my life. I'm not necessarily good at them. I mean, come on. I'm being honest. Yeah, why am I shooting these guys? Oh, I guess I should now. Alright, here we go. Whoa! I guess I didn't have to push very hard there. Drop a mirror, drop a mirror. Let's throw my princess down the stairs here. Ah! I mean, really, during the design meeting, did they really ask themselves, how can we depict the characters going down the stairs, and somebody just said, let's have him spin around like a crazy person, and everybody just threw their papers up in the air and just cheered. That's brilliant. I'd give you a day off, but we're a Japanese company and we don't do that. At least in the 80s. Let's see if we can fix that glitch there. That's better. I prefer to see where the spiky balls of death are coming from. Be careful. See, it looks like I should be getting... Oh, never mind. Oh, I can shoot them? Oh! I don't wanna die. I wanna live and learn and love. Save. Yes. Let's just go this way. I have a strong feeling about this direction. For example, traps I can't actually destroy. let's destroy those spawners before they come back to haunt me. Almost. Ooh! Oh no. These are not looking good. Got one life to go. One life to live. Are you? No. Are you kidding me? I came all this way? Alright. Oh, that's annoying. Risk my life for nothing. Hey, I saw that. Sure. Oh, boss. It's like a boss from Salt Android Cactus. Oh, never mind. No, it's not. Nothing like the boss from Salt Android Cactus. It's funny, there was a an update for that game recently. Mainly like some bug fixes and stuff like that, but one of the notes was Lemon's ponytail now has more movement. Just gotta appreciate that level of commitment from the developer. Oh, hey. Chill out. You're okay. Wow. I'm just gonna stick in the corner if I don't get killed. Don't do it. Ah. I hadn't lost so many lives just getting here. Oh, my first game over. The shame of it all. Do I wish to save? Where's it gonna start me? Yes, I do wish to continue. Alright, wow, we have a... Oh, why? Why do I use the item? I always push the wrong button. As I was trying to say, we have a ton of lives. I miss all the magic we once had. Alright, let's go through this again. Push. I don't have time to waste with you fools. Sorry. Thought race car noises would make my character run a little faster. Yeah, I'm not talking to you. Entirely too long-winded. Clearly I missed something. Careful there. Wait a minute. Did I even have to go around that border? I'm starting to think that, yeah, I didn't have to do that. The only reason for going was to talk to the crazy guy. But, you know, the first time around was well worth it. Relatively speaking. In terms of Dungeon Explorer 2, well worth it. There he is. Ugh. Jeez. Don't die, don't die, don't die. You know, the corner strategies seem to do pretty well. I mean, she's a spaz. I don't have the speed to dodge, like, any of this. But I can shoot it. Let's raise our attack again. He isn't pulling any punches right now. What's that? You've completed two dungeons? Here's a third one, right in your face. I think I've wandered into a Phantasy Star dungeon. That's another series I haven't given any real time to, outside of Phantasy Star Online. Phantasy Star. I always wanted to play one. I've never actually owned the first game, but I remember being super impressed by this game, even, you know, back in the day. You know, I was definitely one of those kids where initially, you know, it was either, you know, NES or Sega Master System. Owning both was something only, you know, the rich spoiled kids got. I had a friend though who had a Master System. I had an S, and I was always fascinated by his Master System because the games just were so bright and colorful compared to the NES. Plus you had, you know, a lot of Sega arcade games. So yeah, one day we actually convinced our parents to let us swap the system for a little bit. And being attacked by robotic hamsters. Responding crazy. So yeah, hey, we got exchange the system for, I don't know, like a week, maybe two. And went out to Blockbuster at the time, which carried Master System games, if you can imagine. I'm poisoned. Isn't that nice? And just, yeah, went crazy. It got Outrun. I wish I could remember half the names. Was it Thunderblade? Is that the name of it? The helicopter game? R-Type was a big one. R-Type left a huge impression on me. That was an amazing game. You know, not too long later, I would end up getting R-Type for the TurboGrafx 16 and being blown away at how incredible it looked, especially compared to the Master System version. The third level is the one that sticks in my mind the most, where you're attacking parts of the ship. You know, the Master System version of the ship is very geometrically shaped. It's very square. TurboGrafx version, much closer to the arcade, is very organic, very rounded, and just seeing rounded anything in a video game was impressive. But yes, Phantasy Star, though. Ooh, I don't know what that is. That's a shield. Is always one of those games that I would see screenshots for, advertisements for, and just look beautiful. Again, bright, vivid graphics. The first-person dungeons. Just really, really look cool. Never had a chance to get it. Or play it. And after, eventually I would end up getting a Genesis and Super Nintendo, and I wasn't really into RPGs that much until I started getting RPGs for the Turbo, and it's like I fell in love with it. Yeah, I had grown out of RPGs, they weren't my thing until I played Cosmic Fantasy II of all games. And that just, like, revitalized my love for RPGs. And I went RPG nuts. Any RPG I can get a hold of, I was all over. A lot of, whatever the TurboGrafx had, definitely. But I moved on to Super Nintendo. And that, of course, had just classic RPGs. And honestly, I feel terrible saying this, but at the time, I'm going to save it. At the time, when you have games like Chrono Trigger or Final Fantasy 3, 6, and then you look at a game like Phantasy Star 2, 3, or 4, there is a prejudice there. You're just like, this doesn't look cool. No, hang on.
Intruder program activated. Accessing scan mode. Scan subject. Greg. Status. Terminated. Inquiry. Cause of termination. Conclusion. You are the chosen. Initiate chosen sequence. This city was built by the survivors of Hyboris. I was programmed to seal it from unworthy eyes. To protect the seal, Greg was appointed guardian.
Greg? The only game with a boss named Greg. I knew a Greg in high school. Anyway. Oh.
master Natas. Victory draws near as our legion grows in number. Yet you seem troubled. Something worries you, my liege.
You seem troubled? How could you tell? Sorry. I don't mean to interrupt the cinematics. Clearly, this is fascinating.
That is but a thorn in our side and easily dispatched. I hold the orb, and this irritant stumbles about blindly. Monsters rise from the depths of every corner of the land and crush all human resistance. Don't waste your time in needless concern.
No! Waste not time! It is wrong! Too much power! Natas will not rest till this threat is crushed, obliterated, exterminated!
Yes.
Seems happy to me, doesn't seem troubled.
It would seem my liege grows senile. How uncertain he's become. The memory of his previous defeat seems to linger in his thoughts. However, he is still recognized as emperor to the armies of darkness. And that is something I still have use for. A visit to Khan is in order. Fly to him now and we'll see that he leaves nothing to chance. He'll be more than a match for those wretched insects. And when they are out of the way, I can turn my attention to more important matters, such as ruling the world.
Maybe I should have left the room before saying that in front of Master Natas. So I'm entering Vax. Where the hell that is. What's this? Yes, I do, Tank. You have no idea how badly I want to race you. Alright then. Holy crap! Well, they weren't kidding. Quick, can we race again? I have a feeling I have to use that dog as a delay tactic. That's right, sit down, little green man. Just an extra life, really? That's it? Wonder if I can race him again for another life. Let's find out. I wanna race him. Oh, his dog is in here. Oh, well now... now I know I can't beat him. Can't cheat anymore. Oh wait, no, there it is. Alright, let's see what happens. Maybe I can do this. Oh, he didn't fall for it. I don't need a rematch, I already won once. So before all this dialogue and this story, I was talking about my utter failure of playing and appreciating Phantasy Star. It's definitely one of those things I want to rectify. I don't know if I'll do it through a live stream, because I mean, that's going to take a long time. I'm not sure if I'll take on any RPG of great length. I definitely want to do Panzer Saga again. I have played Panzer Saga, and I've beaten it a couple times. It's not a terribly long game. It would take several episodes. I mean, like, probably a couple weeks if I keep doing an hour at a time. But it's such a cool game, and so many people just have never seen it and never really experienced it. And it's not one of those games that are expensive just because it's rare. I mean, it's expensive because it is a genuinely good game. Whatever, man. Harry Man. Yeah, that's a whole another topic. Discussing the collector's market. For the time being, I'll just state that I'm not a fan of the collector's market. I think it's pretty ridiculous that gaming has become, that video games have become collectibles. And thus very expensive. It's wasteful and ridiculous. There really is no reason for that to have happened. I mean, it's cool that some games are rare, for sure, but to place such a high value on them, like Panzer, for instance, I mean, $200 to $300 for a game. Is it worth it? No game is worth $200 to $300, I'm sorry. Unless it comes with like an arcade cabinet and monitor and joysticks. It is a fine game though, and more people need to be able to play it. So Panzer will definitely be a game that we will explore. Not sure what game we're going to explore next, though. I don't think I'm going to jump quite into Panzer. I want to do a short game next. Probably a shooter of some sort. I decided what. I know I started off doing Blazing Lasers. I could do that. I could probably cover that in like two episodes, if not one. We'll figure it out. We won't worry about it right now. Right now, let's concentrate on stuffing Natas and his evil henchman who's ready to betray him. Shall I fetch Arden for you? Oh, hey. Very nice. Ooh, look at that transparency effect. Found a hideout. So did the monster set the trap, or did you? Whoa. That was close. Finally, there we go. There, that's better. Speaking of messing with your eyes, yeah, it's like, do I want to try getting the one up or talking to the crazed masturbator? I am curious what he has to say. Walk down. Ever so slightly, I am moving downwards. Should I, or should I just keep going? We're gonna walk down the river. It's not stopping me. My thumb hurts. My thumb hurts a lot. Holding this down as if my life depended on it. I will see what he has to say. Aren't you glad you tuned in? I guarantee you, no other video of Dungeon Explorer 2 on the internet has taken the time to walk down the waterfall to talk to the crazed masturbator. This is a world first, and I'm pretty sure I should have like a wiki entry regarding this feat. I'm gonna walk a little bit past it. Oh man, I really cannot feel my finger. Alright. Oh no, Karn. That was well worth it. We're gonna run into Urza next. A little Magic the Gathering humor there. Kind of feel guilty that I know something about. Wait, sorry. Kill this thing. So annoying. Oof, things are not looking good for Princess here right now. This game really is so much larger than Dungeon Explorer 1. I know I've stated that already, but I'm still in amazement of just how large the game is. Very impressive. I only have 4 life. I'm gonna make this life last. That but I don't want to touch any of these guys. Smack, there we go. We're good. I always enjoy when games criticize you. In this case, it sends out an enemy that can kill you in one hit because you're too dang slow. Cinematics. Messed up like this. It's funny, he's a golem like Karn. Though Karn was more of a robotic construct, I guess. I don't know. There you go. We'll go left. Wow. Evil. Ah. It flashes like you can destroy it, but it looks like that's not gonna happen. Ah, bite. Yeah, I'm not clawing my way back up. Ah, this goes on forever. Should I walk down? There. That worked well. Thank you. Oh, you bastard. That was just rude. Session has gone on a little longer than usual. Got carried away playing Dungeon Explorer. Alright, let's save it here. That's a good place. Not entirely sure where we're supposed to go next, but what else is new? Oh, it's a big stretch there. So, thank you once again for joining me and Mecha Taco as we continue to stumble our way through Dungeon Explorer 2. We obviously made progress tonight. Killed more bosses, saw more scrambled cinemas, and talked about completely irrelevant things. So, it's been a good night. I'll be back tomorrow for more of the same. Times 2, I don't know. I'm gonna look up what that one crystal did. That really bugs me that the color of the UI changed just slightly. I'm also gonna check into some issues with the stream. It looks like I had quite a few dropped frames, and I don't know what's going on with that, so we'll see if we can correct that as well. In any case, I will see you all tomorrow. Take it easy, and good night.